Welcome to Ye Olde Live from Quarantine. My name is Sean Bonnette. I'm gonna keep doing this. This is we're 80 some nights in. And yeah. Breonna Taylor, you'll be remembered as someone who was truly kind. You were a guiding light in your friends and family's life. You should be celebrating your birthday tonight. 27 years ago, you were born in America. And then you lived here until you died. Policemen took your life and how they robbed the world of you. One less EMT, one less daughter, one less black woman, one more martyr. There are too many martyrs. Breonna Taylor, you'll be remembered as someone who cared about people's lives. As for your murderers, no one will remember their names, but justice will be served for their crimes. I wrote that song today in honor of Breonna Taylor, who was an EMT who lived in Louisville, Kentucky, and she was the victim of a no-knock raid on her house when the people that they were looking for were already in custody, and their house was 10 miles away, and she was shot 8 times from people, from police, just busting in on her house and opening fire. So yeah, and today would have been her 27th birthday. And it's a fucking shame to be robbed of your 27th year, because that's a special year. And and during a pandemic now, we have one less EMT, and her family and friends have who by all accounts was a really, really kick-ass friend and daughter and a good person in their life, just snuffed out. So, rest in power, Breonna Taylor. It sucks that you're a martyr. You shouldn't have had to be. And I hope that your death was not pointless. And thank you all for listening. I'm going to do one more kind of morning song before moving into maybe some cheerier territory.
I remember it.
timbre of your voice. I long to hear your voice as I remember it. No recordings were made. Thank you. That song was called Your Voice as I Remember It. Strong Enough by the great Sheryl Crow. Let's do a question or two, eh? Let me see. Here we go. Jay Gaston wants to know, hey Sean, do you ever feel reluctant to perform songs that are recognizably about you or the people around you? I'm always caught between anonymizing my stuff or being truthful. So yeah, that's a really great question. I feel like you should definitely take it on a case-by-case basis, because sometimes, there's no because about that. Definitely take it on a case-by-case basis as far as, like, writing personally and, anonymizing versus making it very explicit. I guess to make a very simple answer out of it, I certainly do feel reluctant to perform songs that are recognizably about me or the people around me, and yet still I do it. And sometimes I'm able to try to mask it enough, make it feel like I'm like, you know, layering it enough where people don't recognize what it's about, but I feel like a lot of people do and just kind of are okay with it, or in some cases not okay with it. I remember my mother recognizing that a lot of songs are about her, and us having a big fight over it at one point. But then later on, we kind of made up about it, and she told me that she was actually proud of some of the songs, proud of me for writing some of the songs. So yeah, it's but you know, one thing that can guide you is that if you're uncomfortable, that's a good sign. You should keep making yourself uncomfortable with what you're writing songs about. I feel like that's generally a sign that you're on the right track. even if it is uncomfortable and unpleasant, which it sure is. But yeah, thank you for the great question. Let's do another song. Tonight is, tonight Tony and I are having date night. We're gonna watch a movie. Which is nice. Enjoy yourself while you can. Let's see. We didn't come here to rock. We only came to disappoint you. 'Cause deep down in your ball sack, that's exactly what you wanted us to do. You wanted us to lead you on. You wanted us to bum you out. So you can build us up. And you can knock us down. If that's what gets your dick hard. Telling people they're bad at making art. You wanted to feel cheated. What you needed, so you're welcome. Don't worry about it. Just lay on the couch. Judge what other people do. Don't do shit for yourself, 'cause I'd hate to see it happen to you. If that's what gets your dick hard, telling people they're bad at making art, feeling just like you're the one in charge. Pissing on my most pathetic part. Thank you so much. That song was called We Didn't Come Here to Rock. I wish there was a we involved in this performance right now, but not tonight. Let's see. But sometimes I pray, because the way I was raised keeps me afraid of a scientist who has to have his way. I subsist on a steady diet of shame. I hope I can forgive me for having the nerve to exist. I hope that someone can help me make some sense of this. I'll work a 10-hour grade from 9 to 7, and I can't fall asleep until 11 past 11. There's no drug I can take that will keep me from being awake past my bedtime. Oh. Truckers are the blood in the veins of the body of America. Are the arms and the legs and the brains and the eyes. And there's a disease and it's spreading from Oregon to Oregon. And you are the platelet cell that fixes the problem. You don't know your own power. You don't know what you're worth. You don't recognize your valor. And until you do, nothing you do will matter. That song is called Truckers Are the Blood. This is a thank you for letting me sing to you. Appreciate it. The song is called Linda Ronstadt. It's my last song of the night. I'll see you tomorrow. Shit in a museum. It was a video installation of Linda Ronstadt. And I really miss my friends, but I don't see them. All I see is this video of Linda Ronstadt. Today the salt and sun ran down my face. After a year of hiding all my feelings, shit in that museum, all from a video installation of Linda Ronstadt. I almost made it through a year of choking down my fears, but they're gone for now, all thanks to Linda Ronstadt. I almost made it through a year of choking down my fears, but they're gone for now, all thanks to Linda Ronstadt. I can handle astounding works of beauty. I think I like my pretty, pretty ugly. But the beautiful soul I witnessed in that movie was an entirely different kind of overwhelming. It was a dog who won't stop barking, like a cut that never stops healing. Arizona sunset in the early evening, or a grown man inconsolably weeping. I almost made it through a year of choking down my fears, but they're gone for now, all thanks to Linda Ronstadt. I almost made it through a year of choking down my fears, but they're gone for now, all thanks to Linda Ronstadt. I almost made it through a year of choking down my fears, but they're gone for now, all thanks to Linda Ronstadt. Every time I play the end of that song, now I hear Kimya Dawson's voice going, I'm just your average slender cat's hoe. Have a good night, everyone.